Hey, what's going on, guys? Wyeth White's Lawn Service here, back with another video. Today, guys, I'm super excited. I'm actually taking my trailer, as you already know from the title of the video, I'm actually gonna take my trailer to get wrapped today. I'll take it to the sign shop, which is a local shop that does the trailer vinyl wrapping, and it should be there for about a week. So I'll finish off this video about a week from now when I pick it up, which will be pretty cool. I'm excited to see the wrap and obviously get this video out to you guys. The trailer wrap's actually something I've been looking to do for quite a while now, and I just haven't gotten to it yet. Personally, it's because I haven't had help. I didn't have help last year, which is when I really wanted to do it, and I didn't have enough help, and I was so busy being solo, it didn't make sense to drop $1,700 into a trailer wrap. But now this year that I'm going to be having help and trying to grow the business a lot, it makes sense to, because the more advertising I can do, the better. Now, before I take it to the shop today, I'm actually going to be hitting up the car wash and cleaning it up really good. As you guys will see when I get out of the truck here in a little bit, it's pretty gross. It's really muddy from over the winter, just driving it around at the end of the season or the winter. I actually live on a dirt road, and of course, behind my truck, it spits up all the mud on the trailer. So I'm going to be having to clean all that off. And of course, white trailers, when they sit over the winter, they actually can get black streaks going down the sides of them. It's perfectly normal, not that big a deal. I got some cleaning supplies that I can clean it up real quick. But this way it's all gone whenever he puts the vinyl wrap on. But anyways, I'm looking forward to dropping it off, and with that, I guess I'll see you at the car wash. Alright guys, we're at the car wash here. There's actually an outdoor bay, which is the only bay that I can fit my enclosed trailer, obviously. It's too wide to fit through anything else. As you can see, the truck is disgusting. The trailer is pretty disgusting as well. I actually don't think I washed it for the last few months of the season, and then this winter, it just kind of gross. And I don't know if you guys can see there, but I have some of those black streaks coming down the sides. It's on both sides of the trailer, but again, I got the cleaner for it, so we should be good. Now, if you guys are wondering what I'm gonna use to get the black streaks off, I actually got this brush here off Amazon for like $18 shipped, so not that big a deal. It's a soft bristle brush, but it should work good. It's extendable, so I can reach all different areas of the trailer here. And then I also got this cleaning solution on Amazon for RV wash and wax, but I read really good things on it for getting black streaks off, so we're gonna give that a shot. And I'm gonna put that into a bucket. My bucket's in the trailer right now. I gotta get it out, but we're gonna put that in a bucket with some water, and I think we're gonna take it one side at a time. We're gonna take it and we're gonna wipe down the one area. We're gonna spray off the whole trailer first with all the water, obviously. Then I'm gonna wipe down one side of it with the cleaning solution, spray it off, then another side, spray it off, and we're just gonna go from there. Alright guys, so I just finished the pre-rinse and the trailer's already looking a lot better, but if I take my finger and I swipe it on there, I can see it turns a lot lighter in color, so there's still a lot of contaminants, obviously. I haven't used the brush yet, so we're gonna start that now. But I did want to show you real quick over here, if you guys can see, I still have all of those black streaks, which is fine. I haven't used the cleaner yet, and my finger, it comes off a little bit, but they're still there. So I'm gonna try that cleaner stuff, and I imagine that that'll make this trailer look really good. And that brush and cleaner and stuff is just for this trailer, and I'm not worried if the trailer gets micro scratches or something. It's just the trailer, but I do want to keep it looking cleaner, especially this season with the having a wrap on it. I definitely want to keep it looking just a little bit nicer. So we'll try that stuff out and see how it works. I'm a Alright guys, so I just finished up the trailer here, and I wanted to show you real quick a quick walk around. Heck, it almost looks like new even. Looks a heck of a lot better here. Got all the dirt off, and I'm really happy with how it turned out. The only thing with this cheap cargo trailer is the frame area is rusting kind of quickly. But here's the other side over here. All the streaks are gone. Well, there's like occasional one here that you can barely see. But if I keep up on my maintenance with this season, now that I have this new cleaner, it'll all come off and it'll all continue looking good, I'm sure. While I was here, I also decided to hit up the rig real quick as well. But I'm gonna run that over to the sign shop real quick and I'll see you in just a second. All right guys, so real quick, I got the trailer there. I'm actually at the shop now, dropping it off to get work done to it. Super excited, and I have to record inside the truck. As you can see, it's super windy outside and we're in a plane kind of area, so there's nothing blocking the wind. So you wouldn't be able to hear me outside. But anyways, dropping the trailer off at the shop and I'll see you guys in about a week. Alright guys, so today is an exciting day. It's actually a week from when I last talked to you guys, and a little over a week I should say. And I dropped it off a week ago and just got the call today actually that the trailer is now done getting wrapped. So I'm going to head out and pick it up now. Super excited to go get it. And actually, as you guys will see in a little bit, I ended up making some changes to the logo. And I'll show you guys a picture of what I was planning to do and then how it actually turned out. But I ended up making some changes, one, because I realized that the original plan wasn't going to work exactly the way that me and the trailer wrap guy had thought. But also, number two, I decided last minute that I wanted to change my business logo a little bit to help with the landscaping side of things. So I think you guys know where I'm getting at with this. But anyways, I'm really excited. Let's go pick it up. All right, guys, we're driving in. Look at it now. There it is, guys. Check that out. You can see it over there. All right, let's get a closer look. Check it out, guys. Here's how the right side turned out, which I think looks pretty cool. Hopefully you guys can see that. I know it's a bit of a shadow over here. We actually ended up changing it. It was gonna say Wyatt's Lawn Mowing Service and then have my number in the grass at the front here. But one thing we decided was, one, I live on a dirt road, so as much as I have the mud flaps and whatnot on my truck, it's still gonna end up getting dirty along the bottom of it there, and we did not want that. So we decided to raise the number up here, and I changed my name so that I could also include landscaping the name. But also, with having my number down here, it would have looked like absolute crap with the door there. The other side was a clean side, and it would look fine, but with the door here, it would look kind of rough. Please do not call, guys. I've said this in previous videos, but seriously, please don't call. Now, one thing about this real quick I do want to mention, I really like the sound of Wyatt's Lawn and Landscape, and I thought it was going to be Wyatt's Lawn and Landscape. He ended up talking me into Wyatt's Lawn and Landscaping, as well as my parents and whatnot, because whenever we work, guys, we're providing a landscaping service. So as much as I like the sound of Wyatt's Lawn and Landscape, he did landscaping, and I was thinking about having him change it to landscape, and I called my parents and a couple other people, and they all said, well, yes, Wyatt's Lawn and Landscape sounds nicer, and it does, especially to my younger generation. Let's face it, most of my clients are older. Probably 75% of my business is older clients, and being more old school people, to all of them, Wyatt's Lawn and Landscaping sounds better. So if it sounds better to them, even if I don't absolutely love it, that's fine, because realistically, this sign is meant to get me more business. This is 7x16, I think, as I've said in previous videos. I did end up going with grass along the bottom here. The reason I did grass is because it looks like my old business cards, but also because it draws your attention to the trailer immediately, and then it focuses on the name, which is important, so people give me a call. We'll go around to the back side of the trailer here, and you guys can see, same thing, got the grass at the bottom with my logo there as well. Now, one thing I'm actually thinking about with this already is this side over here looks pretty bare, and I know the video doesn't do it justice, but my logo and everything here is actually absolutely huge on this trailer in real life. In the video, I'm seeing it doesn't look that big, but trust me, guys, the logo itself is huge, and there is still a decent bit of blank space right here. And so what I'm thinking about is adding adding bulletin points of services I offer over here. It's really simple now, and I don't want to get anything cluttered or anything, but I do have space over there where it does look kind of empty, so I might do something like that. Because then you compare it to this side over here and the name and stuff fills up really good. And then you have the door here. So everything looks really filled in and symmetrical, and you know, it all looks nice. It's just the other side has a lot of blank space in the front part. And actually the funny thing is, because the door being there, my name and number and everything actually looks a lot bigger over here, even though I know it actually isn't. But yeah, guys, so that's how the wrap on the trailer turned out. I'm pretty happy with it so far. Like I said, I love the name Wyatt's Lawn and Landscape without the ing at the end of it. But like I said, the vast majority of my business, older clients. And if older people generally like landscaping instead of landscape, that's fine. You know, to me, lawn and landscape sounds nicer, and that's what most businesses are named. But again, I'm getting this trailer to get more business. And if that's gonna help me get more business, then sure. Realistically, it's pretty small and it shouldn't make much of a difference either way. But yeah, guys, so this is gonna do everything I need it to. The grass is gonna get your attention on the road. It's gonna draw you into the name, which is hopefully gonna send them my way and give them my number. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. If you guys want, make sure to send me some pictures of your trailer wraps. I've seen some out there that are super duper cool. I think my favorite one I've seen so far is from a guy. His business is called Element Lawn Care. Oh man, definitely by far the coolest lawn care trailer wrap I've ever seen. But at the same time, this thing is really simple, really basic, but it does exactly what I need it to do. It has grass in the bottom, so it tells you what industry I'm in, and it draws your attention to the trailer. And then it has my logo on it, which is my new logo that I don't have my business cards or my yard signs yet. So I'm slowly going to switch everything over to that. Anyways, guys, hope you enjoyed today's video. I'm not going to hold you up anymore. Don't forget to comment, like, subscribe if y'all want to see more. And I'll see you in the next one. Peace.